Winter has descended upon town. In the cafe, the Lutefisk Supper Committee is holding its annual planning meeting. It's a few weeks before the Lutheran Church's fundraising dinner, and there are many preparations to make. Volunteers have to be telephoned and organized. Large amounts of potatoes, rutabagas, and lutefisk have to be ordered. Entertainment has to be arranged, and advertisements have to be made. Once the plans are made, the work can begin.
I'd hate to see a bottle on the table.
On the Sunday before the Lutefisk Supper, it's time for church. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Of course, Thursday is that annual religious pilgrimage to Kellier for the Lutefisk dinner. Our young people, confirmands, will be working Wednesday evening, and I think senior high are going to be working Thursday evening at the dinner.
For many years, the Lutefisk Supper has raised money to supplement the offerings and help pay the bills of the small church. When the service is over, everyone goes down to the basement for coffee and conversation. After church, a few of the ladies get together to make lefse for the Lutefisk Supper.
Let the bubbles rise, and just when they get to lovely little brown, then you can get over. Is that beautiful or what?
There has to be enough lefse for about 400 diners.
The best part of making lefse is having it hot, getting to eat it when it's hot.
The lefse roll you get is a big knobby one.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't think that is good to roll it.
We're before already.
Yeah. I'll have to make some material now.
It's not what lefse is supposed to look like.
No.
It's supposed to fold over.
Mine didn't either. Don't put it in there. We can eat it. I'm eating, my mistake.
It's nice to learn, but it's really hard with everybody watching.
I think if we don't keep working and get our young people involved, we're going to lose these traditions that are so important to community and family.
Lutefisk is gross.
I can't believe you're my daughter.
I like it.
Yeah.
I don't.
When it's all done, the lefse will be stored until Thursday, the day of the supper. On Wednesday, the day before the Lutefisk Supper, there is much to be done. In the morning, the rutabagas are peeled and cut into pieces.
Alan, wait.
The rutabagas are brought to the church to be stored overnight.
But actually,
one of our speakers, I think, would be better down here.
So we could either put a big one or a little one down here. They probably don't want a lot of music or sound down here.
They also bring in cookers for keeping food warm during the supper, and some new serving dishes.
Okay.
The lutefisk has arrived, and is being stored in the cooler of the local store. So John is going to make sure the order is all there. Missing some?
Oh.
Oof.
I was supposed to find them, but I said, guys, I'm ready for sure.
Oh, that would have been trouble.
There we are.
Later, in the evening, potatoes are being peeled.
The hiring, don't they earn a...
There was a mystery for years and years back here in America about lutefisk. You know, some of the lutefisk was white and some of it was yellow. They always thought it was two different subspecies of codfish. Well, then one day, I guess it was one of my relatives went back to Norway to visit. They were down on the waterfront where they were hanging up the codfish to dry on the racks. And he noticed that on the bottom row they were yellow. And what the heck, you know? So he said, "Well, why is the codfish on the bottom row yellow?" And one of the guys there said, "Well, you come by in the morning about 5 o'clock. Every dog in Oslo comes along here and waters them down."
A table is needed to set up the coffee on.
We okay?
They're okay, except for the windows. Ooh. I thought they were just screens.
Nothing broken.
They didn't break. One was a screen that fell down first.
Something tells me that's off of our church. Yeah. It's the same color. That means we don't have a storm out here someplace.
Uh-oh.
Oh, well, it's only winter.
Well, for Craig, well, I'm going to break it again.
Okay, you ready? I hope it's too long.
Well...
Yeah. I'll tell you what we'll do. Use this one for the pies.
In there?
In over here. And then we'll take a smaller one.
Well, how about that one?
Maybe? Yeah. We'll move it from back.
I got it. Well, I'm just leaving it right here, huh?
Yeah, right here.
I gotta leave tomorrow noon.
Oh, you're going away?
Here between 6:30 and 7 tomorrow morning. I was out cutting the rutabagas all morning.
Oh, okay, you gotta go straight out. Bunch of junk.
No, I gotta take Donovan.
Take it straight out. This way.
Yeah. The second table still partially covers the door to the furnace room, where the gas range and the lutefisk cooker used for the supper are stored during the rest of the year.
The stove they're going to use, isn't it?
Was it in here? No. Yeah.
There's all their equipment. Okay, I'll tell you what, let's move this. So we're not in the way of the stove.
That'll work.
Okay. this way. The bulky stove is difficult to move.
No, take it back and set it down. We'll have to do something.
Why?
Set it back up. I think I was had intended to paint this summer.
Yeah. Hopefully the old gas stove will light up after its long storage. After a few attempts, the burner ignites. More kids have come in to help.
All right, I can feel the heat over here.
Yeah.
You're cold.
Get
over there.
I like warm rolls. Yes, you do.
Here's
one, two, three, four, five. Here. Try this. We might have to
readjust. Okay, here.
Oh, yeah.
Kids set the tables. Begins early on the morning of the Lutefisk Supper. Rice is boiled for glorified rice. Rutabagas are cut into small pieces to be boiled. Roasts are put in for people who might not like lutefisk. Things cook while the workers take a break. Henry makes a large pot of coffee for the workers that will be coming in. The rutabagas are mashed. The parking lot is plowed.
Yep. You can do it, about to tip it off along here.
It's snowing, Anna.
A couple of years ago, we had trouble with the cat.
It's getting hot in the kitchen, so a fan is set in the window to blow out the steamy air.
This back in the furnace room.
Okay. the glorified rice is started.
That's what happens when you're a Polish lutefisk.
His knees were bad when he was 30 years old.
Who do you put the corned beef in here?
Nothing like last year's lutefisk smell.
Things cook while the workers take a break. The lutefisk cook has arrived to see if things are in order. Musical equipment is set up by Gary, a local band member. Three groups have been gotten to perform in the evening. The potatoes are cut up to be boiled.
And then I usually do the glorified rice that has passed, and then I usually help with the mashing the veggies to the potatoes, but they had the veggies already done.
Draining them for them, so they didn't so wet them.
There we go.
The roasts are done. The potatoes are mashed. Final touches are made. The break table is cleaned off and set. Pies are brought in by local ladies for dessert. There aren't any tickets, so they have to be made in a hurry.
If you give me some money, a quarter is some fun money.
$6 a ticket or
$9.
$9.
I think, isn't it?
The lutefisk arrives at the church.
Well, how about you? Are you an animal?
No. He's loading the other. Where's the girl for school, Richard?
Cut them into pieces, you mean?
Yeah, cut them into about portion size.
Oh, yeah, okay. You don't want to pre-cut them then, huh?
Yeah.
There's probably more. Gufta.
You sure you want to go home?
Sure don't smell like corned beef and cabbage to me.
You wash that usually big kettle. Usually two batches. And then we have trouble with it. It could be stainless steel. We have to put it at sheer rust.
Hey, yeah, right. I mean, yes.
Servers are arriving.
Oh, that wasn't such.
I sleep on the ship.
I don't know how much that fish will display.
That's all we eat is cod.
How do you know when it's done?
You boing it. Boing, 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 sir.
People are starting to arrive. Daryl lets people know when there's a space open for them downstairs.
Perfect. Okay, second table, let me call. Miss the music. So I get the lure. Lots of fish.
Did we get ready?
Yeah, but I think it was name on the guest today.
The dirty dishes are starting to come.
It's always very good.
Almost as good as you.
Well, I hope so.
Got the cookie. Apple. That's about it.
Yeah.
times like this, it's no wonder why Belfast is having a revival. This was the days of Elijah.
I'm going to do the water.
The workers eat as the supper comes to a close.
Everything in this church for 10 years.
It's good. It's the very first anime I ever saw.
Who's the camera guy?
Box.
Not too.
I need that tonight.
Okay, I'll do
it. I don't have
John and Richard discuss how things went and what can be changed for next year.